So because Anna has become the victim which we say it stands for the 1.5 million Jewish children who were murdered. And we got, after another few weeks, we got a letter from the Red Cross, very factual, not with sympathy or anything, telling us that my father and brother had perished in Mauthausen, this terrible Austrian camp, several days before the American army came to liberate that camp. Well, that was the last hope was shattered, and I became extremely depressed. You know, I had always hoped that I would go back to normal again, it would be a family again, but when I realized it can never ever happen again, I was actually more miserable after the war than I was in the camp, because in the camp I had to use all my strength to survive, but once I realized life will never be the same anymore, it was really, really very, very hard. And Otto Frank came to tell us, you know, he said, if you hate people and if you're miserable, you will be miserable. The people you hate, they don't know. So, and he who had lost everything had no hatred, and I never could understand. And he came very often to us, he helped my mother, she had to find a job, and I didn't want to ever turn 16, I didn't want to go to school, and he said to my mother, I have to go to school. So I went to school, but I didn't enjoy being with all the young people, you know, it was really, really hard. And when I finished school, I didn't know what to do, and Otto was a good photographer. He took lots of, you might have seen lots of pictures of Anna and her sister, a good photographer. He and my mother decided that what I should do. And I didn't really care, and I said, okay. And when I was very unhappy in Holland, and Otto knew somebody in London who had a photographic studio, and he got me a job in London. And I came to London in 1951, and I lived in a little boarding house in Cricklewood, and there was a young man who had come from Israel to study economics. And we became friends, we both didn't have any money, we went for long walks, and after 6 months he said to me, Eva, I've fallen in love with you, will you please marry me? And when I finished my studies, we can start a new life and go to Israel. And I said, no, thank you. I was shocked. And I said, well, you know, I've got a widowed mother in Amsterdam, and you can imagine, I would never just go away and leave her. And so, you know, I'm going back here, we'll be over soon, and I go back to Amsterdam then. And then Otto Frank, who kept a bit an eye on me, came over as well. And I told him, I met this young man, and I quite like him. And he asked me to marry him. And I said, no, of course, because I go back to my mom. And Otto said, he got a bit embarrassed. He said, your mother and me have fallen in love as well. And once you have settled, we like to get married ourselves. So I went back to this young man and said, well, I'm married now. So the next year we went to Amsterdam in 1952 and we got married there and we were married for 63 years. And when I tell that in a school, they said, how many husbands? I said, well, just one husband. I can't believe it. And Otto and my mother were married for 27 years. And they work together completely harmonious to with the publication of the diaries, it all the contacts with the different countries, they traveled worldwide, made many, many pen friends, got thousands and thousands of letters which they answered, and every letter personally. And we got 3 daughters and 5 children, and so eventually I got over it, and in 1988 I started to speak for the first time, 88, so many, many years after, and I wrote my first book, and then I wrote my second book, The Promise, and after after Otto got the diary back, I said to my mother, we must go and get a painting from Heinz in the house, which we did. It's amazing paintings, big old paintings. And a few years ago, I donated them to the Resistance Museum in Amsterdam, and they made a big exhibition of it because I wanted to share it with the world. And that is why I wrote as well the book about him, because to keep the promise to Heinz and the father, the Heinz would be forgotten. And besides that, all the many paintings, he wrote as well poetry. He was very, very talented. He taught himself six languages when he was in hiding. He played chess with himself, not with a computer. when you go to the books, I have some pictures, postcards of some of the pictures. But I want to read you with now across the page. Just one poem. Unfortunately, many are very, very sad because, as I say, he was quite afraid of dying. And but some are actually quite cheerful as well. But this one, don't cry, Mama. Mama, do I have to die already? I heard the doctor say so. Please, Mama, don't cry. Heaven is such a beautiful place and soon we'll be together again. Mama, what will my little sister say when she wants to play with me again? Please, Mama, don't cry. After all, I'll be seeing Dad again. He's been waiting upstairs so long already. Remember to take good care of the kitten. She loves me so. Please, Mama, don't cry. Do you still love me as much as ever? Are you still with me? Please tell me, Mama. Please, hold my hands for just a minute. It seems so misty in the room. Please, Mama, don't cry. Mama, just one more thing. Please, kiss me goodbye. Well, on this sad note, I'm afraid I wanted to read it earlier, but this is really my talk in a nutshell. There's, of course, much, much more. How my mother was saved is really another miracle. How my father came to find me is another miracle. And that I'm sitting here, I must say, I have to thank the Russians for it. And I spoke the other day at the Russian Island and at the Russian Community Center, and a man from Russia had brought an exhibition where he showed how many camps the Russians have liberated, and to save perhaps a good 10,000, perhaps 20,000 Jewish people, which is not really known to the world. So, you know, they're not all bad. And Putin, actually, is very pro-Jewish because he has written about it, and he lifted the siege of Leningrad, which is Petersburg, next to a Jewish family, his parents. And the Jewish family saved his parents. So he's very, very grateful to the Jewish people. And Chabad is actually doing very, very well in Russia.